Hey guys, this is NK back with a new tech video, and this is a new PC build for AMD fanboys out there. So let's get into it. The budget is 45 to 50,000 for this PC build. If you are gonna buy it offline, then make sure you just check out for two, three, or as much as possible stores. And if you're online, make sure you check 4 to 5 websites. Buy from the best website as possible. Make sure you are buying from a genuine place and genuine product. So let's get right into the build. So the first thing I have here is the CPU. The CPU is a tricky part because in Amazon, the Ryzen 5 2600 and the Ryzen 7 1700 is priced very, very much similar. So if you are a video editor, Ryzen 7 1700 will perform a bit better than Ryzen 2600. Even though the Ryzen 2600 can also do a good video editing, I don't say it's a bad one, but due to the 8 cores, it will help a lot when it comes for video editing. But Ryzen 5 2600 has a better single core performance, so you can expect better gaming on this 2600, but it is only better coming 2 to 3 FPS. And coming towards the second thing of these processors, Ryzen 1700 is last gen, and whereas the Ryzen 5 2600 is the latest gen. So you can expect long term when it comes for gaming. And even Ryzen 7 2700 is performing very much similar, and it's the old flagship, so that's not a big deal. Any of the processor will go good. I will let it for the personal preference. If you are gonna go with octa core or hexa core video editing, you can select it. Both are really, really good CPUs. Now coming up towards the GPU, we have RX 570. Actually, me and my friend had a discussion about RX 570 and GTX 1650. So which is better? He was telling RX 570 is the clear winner. Let me tell you that sometimes Nvidia cards do better, not in gaming. I'm telling, we electronics students usually do some projects. Sometimes we require Nvidia cards for that one. We did a project with Raspberry Pi where we were able to stream our games to Raspberry Pi. We actually basically converted a Raspberry Pi into a Steam Link device. So that one required Nvidia cards. And let me tell you another thing. That in past there was a application for Android where known as Moonlight, where you can actually stream all your desktop PC games on an iPad or any Android tablet or any Android device. If you had an Android TV, you could also stream games on that one. That was not a great service, but for a long time we didn't had any sort of those service from AMD, but latest we have the Steam Link device and AMD Relive. All are there. It has covered up its region, but still sometimes there are few places where Nvidia has its hold. Okay, but when it comes to gaming, RX 570 is the clear winner. So coming towards this card, this is an 8 GB card. It is also great discounted on Amazon. I saw it for only 14,000. If you are planning to buy, just go and grab it. It's on a great, great price. And it is obviously better than 1650 when it comes for gaming. It can perform better. So coming up towards the third part. Now this is a really crazy part. I didn't go for the cheapest motherboard as I usually do, because for the build I concentrate more over the CPU and GPU. But this time I didn't do that one. I went with a good motherboard. Actually, motherboard also plays a very important role. And if you are gonna keep your PC exposed like me, having with a tempered glass or something like that, then a kick-ass motherboard is must required. So you should go with ASUS EXA330M gaming motherboard for AMD. It has 4 RAM slots and it looks really awesome. That black and white, I mean black and red design. It looks really amazing. As soon as you see this motherboard, I'm sure you'll become a big, big fan of this motherboard. As you can see on the screen, it's a really awesome looking motherboard. If you are going to buy this motherboard, you'll be more than satisfied. And it is priced very well. 5,400 is the best price I can say for this one. And now coming up towards the next part, we have the RAM that is from Corsair Vengeance, 8 gigs RAM. This is at 3000 megahertz, so it's gonna do a good job. Now coming up towards the power supply, as we are using a powerful power supply, that is 550 watt ATP certified power supply from Cooler Master MWE. This is a very good and loyal power supply from Cooler Master. Now the hard drive, the Western Digital Blue, I found it for a bit cheaper price than Seagate today, so I went with Western. Yes, you make sure you just check the price of both the hard drives, Western Digital and Seagate, online and offline everywhere, because sometimes this is priced a bit more, sometimes that is priced a bit more, something like this that is going on. So now coming towards the SSD. SSD is a part where you can just upgrade few in future. Now let me tell you that you just don't go back with graphic card or the CPU. Stick on to this CPU and graphic card just to buy an SSD. Just don't go back with this graphic card, because graphic card is gonna help you out in performance and long term, whereas SSD is not gonna help you out. It is just gonna boot your PC a bit fast. That's it. So that's it for the build, guys. If you enjoyed it, then like, hit that like button, click on the subscribe button, guys. You can see that red button will go white color. I was just joking. If you like the video, then hit like and subscribe to the channel, because I'll be bringing such videos. Thanks for watching.